We're here at Soldier Field for the showdown between the Eagles and the Bears. This is a game today that could come down to the two running backs, two of the real stars of the sport, two players who went in fantasy drafts really high. How do you see this one going down today?
Yeah, and how's your fantasy team?
Well, we won't talk about that.
Let's talk about good things. But, you know, these two teams are stars. You know why? Because we can see how the football team is built. And I think it is no doubt about it. The offensive line is a big part of it. They always have hope. If they block their guy a little bit, these running backs can make a big play out of it.
Hester's lined up in the slot.
First and 10.
He's going to the left. Loading up with extra defensive backs in the dime. Going across the middle. He's wide open for the grab. Touchdown, Chicago.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and, hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
Bears ready to kick the football. Stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Offense lines up here. Vic in shotgun formation. Long ball to DeSean Jackson. He's in the clear. The 10.
What an effort and a touchdown.
There's no doubt about it. When you score like that to tie up the game, it shifts momentum. And it's all up now to the offense of the other team to get back out there and get the momentum back on their side.
Inside of the uprights. The Bears are ready to return the kick. He's a dangerous returner, and he'll have a chance to show you right here. Hester's going to get set in the slot for this snap.
Get ready.
First and 10. Throws to the right, inhales the pass.
Well, there's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, the double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
Hester's handed the football, taking off. Good piece of tackling. It's often the difference maker in any game, and that is how you perform inside the red zone, and we're getting an early taste of that.
No doubt about it, Jim. You got to be creative when you get in the red zone. We'll see what the offense calls.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Under fire on that throw.
Three,
Second down here.
What a hit, and the ball is dropped.
That was a big hit by the defender that time. The receiver drops the football. I'll tell you what, I guarantee the next time he goes over the middle, he'll be looking for that defender.
Fortes in the backfield. Single back set. The throw to the left. Chicago in for the score.
What a tremendous throw by the quarterback that time for the touchdown. What confidence he has in that arm. Small window. Very little room to throw that football in there. He didn't worry about it. Fired it. Got the touchdown.
The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff.
He will run this one back. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. Cooper in the slot. First and 10. Throws the pass. Under pressure and incomplete.
Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
Long ball to DeSean Jackson.
He's got some daylight.
Touchdown!
Well, here we are. It's a tie game now. We'll see how the teams react to it. Will it be positive or negative?
Makes the PAT.
Eagles getting set for the kickoff.
Always a threat, and he'll start his return now. The Bears line up in the pistol offense.
The wide receiver shifting around in motion.
Matt Forte gets it here. Met at the 40-yard line.
The off-tackle run. It's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
Hester's lined up now as a slot receiver. The quarterback will hand it off. Picks up the first and still has some room to run.
That's a bread and butter play by all offenses in the NFL. Get a few yards and get that first down.
Mark Trestman was an interesting pick by the Bears in the offseason, coming over from the Canadian Football League. An unconventional hire, but you've known this coach for a long time, and you think this could be a very good choice for the Bears.
Well, I have followed his career for a long time, Jim. Very successful offensive coordinator in the NFL. Wanted to be a head coach, so he goes to the CFL, the Canadian Football League. What is he?
And the interception by Patrick Chung. He's brought down. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Macklin's a receiver in the slot. Here's the give to LeSean McCoy. After being stopped at the line of scrimmage, it's now second down and 10. Vicks looking long. There's a flag right there.
And he makes the catch.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Roughing the passer, defense.
You took a few of these shots in your day. That's a late hit on the quarterback.
Yeah, nowadays these guys, I believe the quarterback is overprotected. This, to me, this is a bad call. The defensive player feel bad. All he's doing is his job, and he still gets penalized 15 yards.
First down following the penalty. Looking to the right side and throwing. Ball's going to be incomplete. A hit knocked the ball out.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Second down after the incompletion.
Going for the home run. Caught it, but he's out of bounds.
He had an open receiver that time and just misfired on the deep throw.
Yeah, I think he got too excited. The fact that he saw a receiver down the field wide open, he got excited. That's why he overthrew it just a little bit.
The Bears with a nickel look here on defense.
Third and 10, looking long.
Brings it in for the score in the end zone.
Good job on that touchdown. That puts them ahead, and it's always, of course, better to be ahead than behind.
Driving extra point is good. Alex Henry ready for the kickoff. Their catch signal. The Eagles defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
Gets past the first wave.
Good job on the ground there by Matt Forte.
Good job by the running back that time, finding the open hole and picking up those extra yards.
First down here after the run. Staying with the running game on first down.
What a job that time by the offensive line. That hole was so big, you could have drove a car through it. The running back hit it full speed, and that allowed him to get down the field and get that long run.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. On first down, it's back to the ground game. Bears, touchdown.
That was just an awful job, wasn't it, by the defense? I mean, it's first and goal. Well, you know it's going to be a run, or I think you should be playing run. The defense not ready. They get overpowered, and they give up the running touchdown.
The Bears can tie it up with the point after.
No, it's not. It's a fake.
So, put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
You catch a person.
The receiving team has the recovery. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
He's going deep. Ball's picked off.
And he's brought to the ground.
What a terrible job by the quarterback. Nobody's open. Tries to force the pass, and look, what's it turn into? An interception.
They face first down.
Hester's going to secure the handoff.
And he is tackled at the 14.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Hester's going to take the handoff now.
Fights off the hit.
When you run off tackle, one of the things you're looking for is for your tackle to make a good block. And then if you have a lead fullback, can he get past him and block the linebacker to free up the halfback so he can go in between them and get in the secondary and make a big play?
Has the first down. Now looking for more.
Well, good job that time by the defense, getting pressure on the quarterback, but you can't let him break the pocket. Look at this time. He breaks the pocket. He's looking down the field. Nobody open, so he decides to run and picks up some big yards.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
And they pounce on him there.
Number 22.
The Eagles with two extra defensive backs in the dime.
Action fake, getting sacked.
Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Hard to tell exactly what the injury is, Jim, but I can just tell it's a lower part of the body, and, you know, that was a tough hit, and I hope he's able to come back in the game later today.
Third down after the sack.
The defense gets another sack.
You're near midfield. It's fourth down. What do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position. Make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
And as the first quarter comes to a close, we'll take a short break before the beginning of the second here in Chicago, Illinois. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Throw that dumbass arm.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield.
He sends the halfback in motion.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. The catch is made in the secondary.
Good job getting the first down by the offense. A look at the defensive players on the sideline cheering their teammates on. Keep us on the sideline a little longer. That's what they're hoping for.
First down following the long play.
Hester's got it on the handoff.
They tackle him for a loss.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second and 13.
He's looking to the right here on this throw.
In his hands, complete. Touchdown.
The fade route, it's a big part of every offense now in the NFL. We see it here. Look at the receiver. Pins the defender inside. Beautiful throw to the outside. Fade for a touchdown.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. He'll throw it over the middle. And so they convert it here on the two-point try. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, after watching that play, I think it's safe to say you can tell it's an injury to the lower body. Really big hit. Feel bad for the guy. I hope he's okay.
That's a gain of six.
This pass defense gives up more completions in the NFL than any other coverage by far. Yeah, they're stopping the deep passes down the field, four guys deep, but nobody's there to stop all the ones going across.
And almost picked off.
I know his quarterback coach is going to yell at him when he goes to the sideline. When you're throwing the long pass down the field, don't underthrow it like that.
This is third down.
Vic's going to take it from the gun.
And he's almost intercepted.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field, and my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Michael Vick backed off the line, shotgun formation. Looking across the middle,
and intercepted.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
They come out of the dime package.
Let's go.
First and 10. Going across the middle. Incompletion on that hurry throw.
Second down following that incompletion.
To Marshall. Hauls it in deep down the middle.
Nothing like a receiver who can just put his head down and go after the football. That's what he did that time. Nice throw by the quarterback. Watch the receiver at the last second, looks up and makes the catch.
To Marshall. And they can't connect. Hester's lined up in the slot. Handoff. And he'll go to the left. And that's good for only a yard or two.
Nickel formation here for the defense. There's some shifting around in the backfield.
Third and 7.
With two hands, he has it. Good, solid tackle. Short of the first, and now we've got a fourth down situation.
A timeout charge to the offense. Forte's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Throws the pass. This is going to set up a change of possession.
Terrible game management that time by the coach. It's three downs. It's fourth down. What should you do? Well, I think you should punt it. He goes for it and puts his defense in a tough position.
Michael Vick will take it from the gun. Brings it into his body. Gain of 16.
Well, that time it's a short pass to the receiver, and I give him all the credit. He takes a short pass and turns it into a long gain. He has the move to get it done, and he did that time.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
An incompletion right there, but it really should have been an interception. The Eagles come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide.
When you play zone in the NFL, what you're trying to do is make the quarterback hold the football just for a half a second longer, and you hope the pass rush can get there. They don't that time. That's why he got the completion. Good job by the offense. They're in the red zones. They're down by more than seven. But the defense, can you stop them and just give up the field goal try?
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
He'll throw it over the middle. Touchdown and drawing close.
What a good job by the offense driving down and getting that touchdown. Even though they're still behind, they're chipping away at this lead, keeping the pressure on their opponents.
Lining up now for the two. Dicks back in shotgun formation. And they will not convert here on the two-point conversion. Good stand by the defense.
The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick.
It looks like the onside kick's going to pay off here. Kicking team appears to have the ball. The Eagles come to the line with an empty backfield. Catch is made, muscles through the defender. Eagles in for the score.
Nowadays, so many kids, they grow up, they want to be wide receivers. I don't blame them. They're out there, they get to catch the football, they get to score touchdowns, they get to do dances, and you're not really allowed to hit them either. What a job.
They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. So they get the touchdown, but they go for two and fail to convert.
I'll be the first to say it. That was a terrible decision to go for the 2 points. I'll give the defense some credit, but mainly the blame goes to the offensive play call.
They're setting up return. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Now a first down from the gun. Launches it down the field. Incomplete.
That's what you have to do as a defensive back. You got to wait till the last second. Wait till the receiver uses his hands. And once they go up, put your hand in between them and knock that football down. What a play.
Hester's taking the handoff. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Nothing like seeing a complete offense. That's what we're watching here today. Yes, we know they can throw it, but what they're showing us here, they can grind out some first downs running the football too.
Ball is out. The defense has it. And now we reach the two-minute warning.
How do you
here
feel
in the
blowing
second
out of that finger there?
Well, the one thing we know about the NFL, when you have the football in your hands, they are going to attack it. You got to know that as a ball carrier, protect it a lot better.
So the boys in the booth, they want to make doubly sure the call was correct. Under 2 minutes, they decided, hey, we need to take another look at this. But the play stands as is.
Yeah, Jim, it was a good challenge upstairs by the officials. It was not clear cut, but once we have seen the play in slow motion replay, well, now it's clear cut now.
A lot of athleticism on display right there. Two battling for the football, and no one able to come away with it.
You said it right. Two tremendous athletes, but a good job by the defense that time. They won out. Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. Eagles in the end zone.
Nothing like having a quarterback who has a good arm who can just fire that football into some tight spots. And then it helps when your receiver has got the talent and the courage to go in there and make that tough catch.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. Looking for an open. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure two extra points. It looks like they've recovered the onside kick.
Well, the flag is out. That football did not travel 10 yards on the onside kick, and the officials saw it. First down on the way. The formation here, shotgun, looking across the middle. Huge yardage picked up and finally tackled at the end.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than seven, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
Touchdown. This game is tight.
You know, if you're a defensive player and you're covering a receiver down here on first and goal, you don't have to cover that much area. That's a terrible job by the defense giving up that touchdown pass.
Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away. They're lining up here for the onside kick. That kick ball comes out. The kicking team recovers, and here they go.
One of the reasons why you put all those fast guys on your kicking team, so when that football comes loose like it did then, your guys can react and recover the fumble.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Almost intercepted.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a quarter route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
Coming up, second down. Hester's handed the football. Running to his right. It's away from the stack. Land. Touchdown.
How about the blocking up front? Lets the running back get in the secondary, and he is so quick and elusive, he avoids the tackles and takes it all the way for the touchdown.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for the put and additional. 2 points on the board as they convert. They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. The receiving team has the recovery. First down, offense readying for the snap. Throws to the right. And that ball's nearly picked off, but he dropped it. It was a jump ball, in essence, for that throw, and in the end, the defense was able to make the play and deny the completion.
In the NFL, it's always about the most physical guy wins, and that time it was the defensive player. Good job.
And they bring him down at the 33-yard line.
Good job by the quarterback that time. Makes the decision. Throws it short. It does not get the first down, but I promise you, third and short is a lot easier than having third and long.
Unable to complete that one, and that's a very quick three and out. Offense lines up here. Jeremy Macklin makes the grab. The Eagles call a timeout, their first.
Bad play call that time by the defensive coordinator. It's fourth and short. There's only a couple plays you know the offense is going to run. They were not ready, and they give up a big first down.
First down here after the completion. Vic going to take the snap from the shotgun. A timeout charge to the offensive unit.
The old-fashioned way of picking up big yardage is running the fly route on the outside, show the speed of the receiver and the strength of the quarterback's arm. What a nice completion.
That reception gave them the first down. Vic in shotgun formation. Escaping the pressure. Runs it across for the score. Touchdown.
In today's game, you know, Jim, you always have to be alert. In situations when the quarterback drops back to pass, you got to think he might be able to run out of the pocket. And that time, the defense not alert for it. Nobody's there, and he scrambles in for a touchdown.
Michael Vick will take it from the gun. Got a touchdown, got a two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do, and you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
Hester's got a chance to return this one. And he spins away, and they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left. No one in sight. Has the grab. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play-action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion.
Trent Cole gets to the quarterback. The Bears signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining. This will be second down. Down the field. Makes the catch. End zone bound, and he's got the touchdown.
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game in the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
Let's go. Lining up now for the two-point conversion. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. Robbie Gold ready to kick it. They're setting up the return. Tackle down at the 42-yard line. One more snap in halftime. Looking to the right side and throwing. And that's a gain of maybe 5. That does it for the first half. Eagles trail in this one. We're back here now in this one where the Bears lead by 1. The onside kick is turned away and the receiving team has it. Michael Vick backed off the line, shotgun formation. And here we go, the first snap of the second half. Here's the pass, and it's broken up incomplete.
Good job by the cornerback reading the wide receiver. He is all over him, and it makes it easy for him to swat down the throw by the QB.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
They've got a first down now after that catch. Looking to scramble, makes the catch in open space.
Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
The Eagles with an empty backfield look here. Sticks to his hands.
Good play call that time by the offensive coordinator. Down inside, when you're inside that 20-yard line or the red zone, find ways to complete the pass. They did that time.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. Incomplete. The Eagles will use a timeout here early in the second half. Michael Vick backed off the line, shotgun formation. Reaches out, touchdown, Philadelphia Eagles.
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead.
Lining up now for the two. going across the middle. You talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. Offense lines up here. First and 10, Hester's going to secure the handoff. And that last play made by Pat Chung.
Good job that time by the offense. Power run gets him a few yards.
Second and 4 following the run. Out of the gun. Trying to work that left side. And he was wide open. Touchdown, Chicago Bears.
Well, that score ties the game up. Now on the defensive side, you got to come out there and take advantage of this feeling you got going now and get the football back for your offense.
They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. The receiving team has the recovery. Defense comes out in the nickel. Vic in shotgun formation. Interception. Nice tackle.
Well, I have to say, that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
First down here. We'll go ground. That's a 3-yard gain. Will be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying we're tougher than you are and we're just going to come right at you.
What you saw there was a good job by the wide receiver. Run that curl route and then see the quarterback, watch the ball, then attack it. Good job of getting your hands on there and making the catch.
First and 10. Hester's going to take the handoff now for a gain of about 5.
An off-tackle run, it's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
Second and 6. Up the middle.
Number 12 with the carry. Gain of 2 on the play.
Hester's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Third and 3. He brings it in here, and he's got the first. Another third down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch. Third
Setting up in the pistol on this play.
The quarterback motions the wide receiver. First down and 10. Matt Forte to the right side. And he's brought down right at the 42.
That was a running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
Wide receiver in motion.
It's a second and 4.
The handoff to Matt Forte.
Has the first down and a whole lot more. Breaks the long one for the touchdown.
To me, still one of the most exciting plays in NFL football. A long running play for a touchdown. And how about that one? It had it all in its feet. Good moves, good blocks. Exciting touchdown.
Brandon Marshall brings it in.
That hurts. The two-point try is denied. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation.
The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it.
It's first down as they head to the line.
Challenging the defenders to the right sides, and that pass is going out of bounds. Incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down.
Throws to the right. That ball is picked off.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did. They got the interception.
Lined up in the pistol formation. Matt Forte gets it here. A tackle behind the line.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Second and 11.
To the ground here. Slashing to the right side. And Patrick Chung is able to bring him down.
Well, that was a nice run that time off tackle. And listen, this is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get in that secondary and make a nice run out of it?
Third down now. 15 minutes to go. Back after this word from your local station.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. The final quarter begins with this snap.
Ball slipped out of his hands.
All you have to do is watch the head of the receiver. When they drop footballs, usually it's because you can see their head move the other way before the football gets there. That's what happened this time, and it's a drop pass.
Hester's in the slot. Takes the snap from the shotgun. Looking to the right side and throwing. Tucks it under, now throws, and it's incomplete.
Well, they don't get it on fourth down. That was a quick drive, wasn't it, Jim? That was just bad play calling, bad execution, and go to the sideline. That's where you deserve to be.
Selleck's usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time. Jeremy Maclin makes the grab.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
He'll fire it out to the left. Right where it had to be.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. That catch, good for a first down.
Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
Throws the pass. Six in the books.
And what a touchdown there for the offense. The quarterback just fires that football in there. Look at the defenders around the receiver, but the receiver big enough, tough enough to go up in there and make that catch.
And the point after is good.
The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick.
Taking it back the other way. Breaks free, has some space to work with.
Well, one of the reasons why you put your fast guys on the kicking team, because you want them to run down there and hit the returners hard. That was a great hit, causes a fumble, and they recover.
The Eagles come to the line with five wideouts and no one in the backfield.
Oh, that could have been intercepted, but he couldn't hold on.
Play doesn't even have time to develop. The quarterback is under so much pressure, he's throwing it before these receivers are even ready.
Offense lines up here. Second and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. He stacked up at that point.
Well, the defense, they give up a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
Now first and 10. And he hauls it in. Touchdown.
It was a short route by the receiver. He catches it and goes all the way down the field and scores the touchdown. And the quarterback looks to the coach and goes, hey, it was a heck of a throw.
Going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
The receiving team has the recovery.
Forte lined up in the backfield. First and 10, Pesters got it on the handoff.
They deck him in the backfield. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
I don't even want to speculate what the injury is, but I think it's safe to say by just watching the player, he's in a lot of pain, and I hope it's not serious.
Second down now. And D'Amico Ryans makes the tackle.
Good job by the play caller that time. Calling for the short pass. Even though it comes up short of the first down, it opens up many things that you can do on third. You can run a reverse, draw plays, screen plays, or if you want, you can still throw it down the field.
Nice catch.
You throw it deep for a lot of reasons. One, you're hoping for the big play, maybe a touchdown, but also you got to think about interference. You can get that a lot of times. But that was a nice throw and catch.
This play set up by the long gainer. Forte's taking the handoff.
coughed up the football. The defense has the football. In on the stop. The Eagles lined up. Everybody split out wide. They spot it at the 42.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open. Yards after the catch, that is what has been killing this defense all year. You got to make the tackle on these short throws. They didn't. A good job by the receiver.
Well, as the clock is winding down, the offense would like to just run it out.
Vicks looking long. Holt, touchdown.
When you got a lead, you march down the field and you add on to that lead with a touchdown, it's fun to watch the other team. Will they stay patient or will they panic? My bet is they'll panic.
Count it. They're lining up here for the onside kick. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. Bennett's lined up now as a slot receiver. Here comes the wide receiver in motion. Throwing now to his left.
That ball has been picked off. Tackle's made.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football, the results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Vicks got it in the gun. Makes the catch. And they knock him down just a yard away from the first.
That was a nice job by the offense. It just puts him in a better position. Nice little throw and catch.
Vicks standing back in the shotgun ready for the snap.
Vicks looking long.
And sailing out of bounds. We've hit the 2-minute warning in the second half. Eagles are at the line of scrimmage with a spread formation. It's off the mark.
Well, Jim, I can't say that's great defense. That's just a poor throw and a poor route run by the wide receiver.
Nickel formation for the defense here. Vick's going to take it from the gun.
Interception. Bringing the play to an end.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The defense comes out of the nickel. First and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. And it's knocked down. Incomplete.
Well, it's a good thing that linebacker knocked that pass down because I don't think he could have caught it. So if he can't catch it, knock it down so nobody else can catch it.
Oh,
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Second and 10. Setting up a little screen.
Well, that's a nice completion by the offense. And what it does, it just puts them in a more manageable situation so they can pick up that third down.
Let's see what they do on this third down situation.
Looking for an open receiver on the right. He had it, but the hit jars the ball loose.
Does it take talent to do something like this? You've got to time the pass, where the football's going, where the receiver's going to catch it, and do the perfect timing. Hit that receiver, and that football comes flying out. Nice job that time. Incomplete pass.
Nickel formation here for the defense. It's intercepted, and that's going to end the comeback attempt. That brings the play to an end.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
First down coming up.
Michael Vick will take it from the gun.
Challenging the defenders to the right side. It's incomplete. The defender had it for a moment, but could not pick it off cleanly.
And here we have second down.
Vick in shotgun formation.
Rocks him with that hit, and the ball's going to fall incomplete.
You might as well catch it, because you're going to take the big hit no matter what. That time, the receiver lets the ball go because he was worried about the defender making the hit.
Avance, a receiver in the slot. Third and 10. Middle. The tackle was made short of the first, and that'll bring up fourth down. Michael Vick backed off the line, shotgun formation. He wants to go deep. Hauls it in, deep down the middle.
When you play man-to-man against this receiver, you're going to have a tough time. Quarterback's a good thrower. Really hard for a defensive back to stay with him.
Here's the first snap after the big play.
Looking across the middle, he has the grab. Ball is out. A recovery by the defense. Going to take it the distance. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
That's a terrible job by the offense. They just give the ball up. Well, the defense says, hey, we'll take it. And look at that, to take it all the way back for the score.
Inside the last 2 minutes, this one had to be instigated by the folks upstairs. They challenged the call on the field, and in fact, it was the proper thing to do. The play is overturned.
Yeah, good job by the officials upstairs, seeing it, knowing there was a mistake on the field. That's what I love about the NFL. Not afraid to admit, to say they made mistakes and turn them around. This defensive coordinator, he is one aggressive dude. He keeps going after this offense. And finally, he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Throws to the right. Touchdown. That'll close the gap.
That's a wonderful touchdown. Close the gap under 2 minutes to go. There's no doubt what you're going to do now. They're going to onside kick. And what we've seen in the league this year, we've seen about 10 different ways. Can the defense be ready?
They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. First and 10. LeSean McCoy takes the handoff. He's brought to a halt. The Bears are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
That's a nice job blocking by the offensive line and a really good job by the running back. Seeing the proper hole, gets up in there and picks up big yards.
Takes a knee. No surprise, they immediately call the timeout.
How you feel doing all that gay ass shit, man? That faggot. Dude, you're ass faggot. Yeah, go ahead and turn
now
down.
Now they'll try over again on second down. Wow, yeah, looks like faggot. The defense encroached.
That's all you could do.
Entrenchment defense. Still second down.
They bring in the extra tight end.
Takes a knee. The Bears have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. And this will probably wrap things up here. The Eagles getting set for the field goal try. A tightly contested contest that has now come to a conclusion.